What's up guys, Deal Advisor here, and today's the day we're gonna review this watch. First, I'm gonna talk about pros of this watch. Then we're gonna take a look how it combines with various colors, how it looks, how it matches with different colors. Then I'm gonna talk about the cons of this watch. And let's get into it. And I want to start with the box of this watch. I want to mention how high quality box this is. It's built very well, it feels very well, it has attention to details even, guys. Look at the bottom of it. It has this soft, nice, sweatish materials. Overall, it's such a good box, guys. I'm really impressed with the quality of it, with the feeling of it, and overall the unboxing experience was really nice on this watch. And you can find the unboxing of this watch on my channel. Make sure to check it out. You may find some valuable content there as well. The only downside of this box is that it has glue smell in it, okay? Just to keep you informed about this box, but overall a very nice box. And let's get finally to the watch. And first, let's talk about the watch, the main watch components of this watch: the movement and the bracelet. So about the movement, I want to tell you guys that the movement is really nice. It's Solitas SW blah 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 movement. Let's be clear here, okay? I'm not gonna go deep into the specs, how it performs, etc, etc. And I don't know what the movement it's called. I'm the end consumer, okay? I don't pay attention to that that much. The key here is that the movement is really robust. It passed the test of time. It's easy to maintain, to service this watch, because majority of watchmakers in your town will be able to service this watch, and it will not cost you a lot of money, okay? Like it will cost if you take to serve some in-house movement, okay? And for the starters out there, if this is your first luxury watch, this is gonna be your first luxury watch, as it's for me, I think it's a really good deal. And one more thing I want to tell you about the movement: it's really quiet movement, okay guys? Some watches, like let me show you, by the way, this is the watch roll it came with. So this Seiko Sarbo 6.5 is really, really loud. Hear to this. When you move the watch, you can hear it pretty easily. With Monta Noble, it's quite movement, okay? You'll not hear it as much. It's a really quiet movement, and that's good too, as for me. And the next thing I want to talk about is the bracelet. So keep in mind that I have a really small wrist, as you may notice already. I have 6-inch wrist, really, really small wrist, and you can see that the watch looks good anyway. Of course, it will look better on the bigger wrist, but even on a small wrist like mine, it looks really good. There's no problem at all with the length of the clasp. Many people are worried about that. I think it's okay. So yeah, the bracelet. You have seen probably how it tapers. You can look at this like for many, many hours and don't get enough of this bracelet, because it's really, really nice. But there's one downside of this bracelet, and we'll talk about later on this video. But overall, the comfort, the feeling, and overall the bracelet is really, really nice. And it can compete with watches that are more expensive than this watch is. For example, a Rolex watch does not have this like separate articulating links. I believe there are one piece, this is the one piece in a Rolex Submariner, for example. And in this watch you get this fully articulating links. A really, really comfortable watch, and when you wear it, you kind of forget about it. You forget that you have watch on your wrist, okay? Because it feels so natural on your wrist. You become one part with the watch, okay? That's the main point I want to tell you. So really, really comfortable bracelet, easy to wear, nice feeling, etc., etc. Really nice bracelet. The next thing I want to tell you, the third point for me, is the design of this watch. I think this is the most timeless design that Monta currently has. This is a dressy kind of sporty watch that they finally released previous year. I really wanted to see something like that, and they introduced that. And the dial is beautiful. We'll talk about the dial, the hands in a minute. The overall design, I believe it's very simple, very stylish at the same point, and it's very special. For me, it's really unique and good design overall. And I believe it will age well in the future. It will still look good. It will still pop, okay? The way how it plays with light, the way how dial looks, every single time I look at this watch, I think, wow, damn, it's kind of different every time, and every time it's beautiful. So many people have concern about this date window. Yeah, it probably will look cleaner without it, but it's a feature that it offers, and I love having date windows. For me, it's a good to have feature, okay, for me. Guys, I want to tell you, some people would love to see the date window in the same color as the dial is, but guys, I can tell you that even in the blue, with the blue dial, the date window is looking good in person, and even in this video you can see that it's just not hurting your eye. You don't pay attention to it. It's not popping, okay, that much. I don't know, I like the frame around it, how it glares, and the quality, guys. Even the text on the date is glossy, okay? It's not made black, okay? When the light hits, it's like, I don't know, it's not probably visible on the video, but it is like, it has glossiness to it. The whole watch is kind of glossy, and you either like it or not, okay? Look at this. I don't know how they are called. I'm sorry, I'm not that good at English. These things remind of kind of diamonds. I don't know, when sometimes the light hits them, they shine so bright. It seems like they're diamonds and not just stainless, and not just polished stainless steel, okay? Another thing I want to talk about is the hands. The second minute and hour hands are beautiful, guys. Every time you look at this dial, you see more details in it. Look at this. So this becomes like one single minute hand, okay? The hour hand is becoming like hidden under the minute hand, and it looks so clean, guys. They put so much thought into the design of this watch. The dial has been manufactured for 18 months. Can you imagine that? 18 months. When I first saw this watch, I thought it kind of is blue and going to black. But actually, I believe this goes to very, very dark purple. This thought is getting confirmed by this circle around the dial. As you can see here on this part, it's purple. And on the dial, it goes to really, really dark purple and then to black. And sometimes when the light hits this watch, you can see that, okay? It's really, really beautiful dial, and I cannot get enough of it. So another pro on this watch is that it's really versatile. When I was choosing between the blue one and the white one, I went with the blue one, but I kept in mind that it will not be versatile. I thought that the white is really versatile, it really is, but I thought that the blue is not. I thought it will be hard to wear it with different kind of outfits, but it's not. It's really versatile. It is versatile both in terms of the color combination, like how you can combine it with different outfits, and it is also versatile as a watch model itself. It has 150 water resistant, so you will not have problems with that. And it's so, as I've said, it's both versatile from the outfit perspective and the watch perspective as well. So you can dress it up, dress it down, you can wear it on different occasions, and I think it's really, really important when it comes to your first luxury watch, especially because this is my first luxury watch. Okay, the last thing I want to mention on the pros is the shape of overall proportions of this watch. It's balanced so well. I fell in love when I seen the profile of this watch. They've put so much thought into this watch. I really appreciate that. The bracelet that has this quick adjustment, it's all the details that make the difference, okay? And I think this is a gorgeous watch. I really love it. But of course, nothing is perfect and everything has its cons. So let's talk about the cons of Monta Noble. The first con I want to talk about is the sound of the bracelet, guys, okay? I don't know if you can hear now, but I'll close up to the microphone so you can hear this. And even if you, and even when you wear this watch, when you move your hand like this, it's a really disappointing sound. I'll probably put some oil on the links to get rid of this sound, but it's kind of disappointing to pay this money. For this price, I didn't expect this sound, okay? I didn't want to hear something like that, okay? I want everything to be top-notch. The next small con on this watch downside is about engravings of Monta logos. What I'm talking about, the logo is engraved in the crown and in the bracelet here on the clasp. And what I don't like about this, the feeling is not that smooth. Of course, you don't always like put your finger on it. You don't always feel that. But when I first got this, I've paid attention to that. I'm a person who like pays attention to details, and that's what I noticed and didn't like, because the feeling is not great at all. It's like sharp and edgy. It's not smooth. For example, in the Rolex watch, the logo is kind of, so you get the idea. I'll show you the pics of Rolex, both on the clasp and the crown. The logo is not engraved, but it kind of pops out, and I believe that's better experience than this is. But yeah, something to keep in mind. So small detail, but nevertheless, the next downside, it's arguably downside, but it really pissed me off. I'm talking about the protective plastic on this watch. And the thing is, the last protective plastic that I've removed was 2 weeks after wearing this watch. There were so many little protective plastics on this watch, like even on these like small links, everywhere on this watch, on this link here, everywhere there are so many protective plastics. And I initially thought that I removed all of it on the first day, but after wearing it, I started to notice after a week that there's some plastic that peeling off. I've peeled it off. I thought that's the last one. Then after 2 weeks, literally yesterday, I found another protective plastic and I've peeled it off. And I don't know, maybe some more left. I don't know, okay? But I believe that was the last one. So of course it's a good thing as well that it's the watch is protected and you'll not get a scratched watch, but it was really tough to remove. In some places I was like trying 2 minutes to peel it off and it didn't came out, but finally I get that. So small things that pissed me off. Let's go further. The last thing I want to talk about is the crown of this watch. The shape of it, the feel of it, and so on. I really don't like this crown. I think it looks good. Maybe it's a bit big, but it's looking good. It fits the watch, but the shape of the crown is not smooth either. I understand it's for more comfortable operating of this watch, but guys, what's the problem of it? Okay, let's talk about the problems that it causes. So I usually wear my watch, I've seen that many people wear their watch on this part of the wrist, but I like wearing my watch here. And the problem that I get with this particular watch is that it hurts my hand. Okay, I started to notice that on this part of my wrist I've been getting some red marks. Okay, move to the point that it started to hurt, and I started to wear my Monta Noble here. This is probably the proper way to wear it, I don't know, but there's something to pay attention to. Okay, for comparison I'll put on my Seiko to show you the difference. Okay, so guys, for Seiko, look how smooth it is. It's easy to operate, it's rounded, it doesn't have sharp edges. That's like this, the crown on the Seiko doesn't hurt at all, even when I wear it like I usually wear my watch. So it doesn't hurt at all. It's easy to wear, it's comfortable, etc., etc., and I have no problems with Seiko with the crown. But here, guys, this crown is really big, and I think because of the watch is so thin. I'll show you with compared to my Invicta, guys, it's almost touching the wrist. Okay, because the watch is so thin. With Invicta you have really big space between the watch and the crown and your wrist. So this is how Invicta Pro Diver looks on my wrist, you can see. And again, no problems with the crown. I'm wearing it here on this like moving part of my wrist. Okay, I have no problems at all here. But with Monta the problems came in. And as I'm not used to wearing my watch kind of far on the wrist, I've started to notice that my hand is hurting. I don't know, there's something to notice, but hopefully it will be okay in the future. So guys, something to keep in mind, okay? I don't know how you wear your watch, but keep in mind that it might be a problem for you as well. So guys, I know this was a long video, but I hope it was worth watching, and I hope it was helpful to you. And you can decide if it's a good deal for you or not. For me, it's I think it was a great deal, and I can tell you that I do not regret getting this watch at all. Every time I wear it, it really like kind of even the sun came, okay, when I started to talk about this watch. It's really beautiful watch, and I absolutely do not regret it. I think it's a good deal for the money you pay for it, because you can't basically get many watches on this price point that are built and overall give you so much for the price. So definitely a good deal for me, and I hope that this video will help you to make up your mind, and maybe you'll end up buying one as well. So thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to my channel, and see you guys in the next one. Have good deals.